Yeah, hi folks, it's Matt Allington here, and in my short video today I'm going to talk about the topic that I'm calling Poor Man's Paginated Reports. So you know what a paginated report is, right? It's when you need to get like a printout or maybe a PDF version of a document. It's typically got many pages. So, you know, Power BI is great for some things. It's great for a single page where you interact and cross-filter and all those sorts of things. But what if you need a 200-page printout of all of your customers, what their total sales would be, and maybe the last date that they place an order? So this is a valid use case, and this is where paginated reports come into their own. Now, the trouble with paginated reports in the Microsoft Power BI world is that it's a completely new experience. There's a completely new tool where you actually have to build paginated reports, and it's not as simple and easy as you might hope. And so I'm going to show you today how you can actually produce your own paginated reports without ever having to touch Paginated Report Builder. So let's jump over and I'll show you a demo. All right, so let me start with the end in mind. So this is what I mean by a paginated report. And you can probably tell that this is being produced inside Excel, and that's exactly what I'm going to show you how to do shortly. So this is an Excel output, but note a few things. First of all, the number of pages in this report, if I come here and switch this view, you can see that the number of pages, there's 250 pages in this report. Also notice that it's PDF, and as I go through the pages, if I just use sort of page down here, notice how the headings are repeating at the top, and I'm getting basically lists and tables of data to be able to either keep as a PDF, or maybe I need to print it and put it into a folder. The use case is not important. The point is there is valid uses for this type of paginated report, and now I'm going to show you how you can produce this using Excel and also Power BI Desktop with very little coding. Now I'm going to use the technique which I first blogged about back in January 2017, so that's 5 years ago at the time of recording this video. And I think I learned this from Chris Webb or maybe Marco Russo or maybe a bit of both. But basically this blog article, and I'll link this in the video and also in this blog article, explains how you can actually extract a table of data from an underlying data model. Now you can do this if you've got Power Pivot for Excel. You can also use some of the new third-party tools to connect Excel on your desktop through to Power BI Desktop on your desktop. And you can also use the same technique if you're using Analyze in Excel from Excel up to powerbi.com. I'm not going to go into all the details of those different variations. I'm going to do it on my desktop, but the principles are still the same. So if you'd like to read this article, come and find more about it, but I'm not going to repeat that within this article here. Okay, so the first thing to do is to actually build the table visual that I want to see within my poor man's paginated report. So to do that, I'm going to use the table visual here, and I'll just give it a bit more screen real estate. I don't really need a lot of screen real estate. I just need to be able to see what it is that I'm building. And so this is going to be a customer report. So I'm going to go to my customers table and I'll grab the customer key, the customer name and their address. And then I'm going to go and grab a measure. I've got a total sales measure. I also will add an order quantity. I don't have a measure, but I'm just going to use an implicit measure, that's fine in this case. And I'd also like to know when's the last date that they place an order. I also don't have that as a measure, but I can just take the order date and change this implicit measure to the latest value. So this basically gives me the table that I want, but there are many, many rows in this table, and this particular view inside Power BI Desktop is not the best way to consume this material. And so now what I want to do is get it into a paginated report inside Excel. Now, I'm going to use a little trick here. So I'm going to turn on Performance Analyzer and start recording, and then I'm going to refresh this table visual. Now, when I do that, you'll note that I get this query that's generated here. And if I copy that query, the next thing I'm going to do is actually try and materialize this query inside Dax Studio. Now, I'm only doing this to show you what's happening under the hood. You actually don't need to do this in Dax Studio. You can just jump to the end state, but I'm going to show you exactly what happens here. So I've got a few third-party tools here, so I'm going to fire up Dax Studio. I've copied that query to the clipboard. And I'll just put this in full screen and I'll run that query. You can see the query that was written by Power BI Desktop in order to generate the table visual inside Power BI Desktop. And when I run that query, this is what gets generated down the bottom here. Now, it's worth pointing out that there is a total row here. This total row is needed in order to be able to populate this total row here. I really don't want that in my Paginated report. So rather than try and edit the DAX, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to come up here, go to totals, and I'll turn off the total row. And then I'll clear here, refresh the visuals, and do the same thing again. I'm going to copy that query, come over here to Dax Studio, and I'll just paste and run that again. And so now we have this table. Now it's also worth pointing out here that there's only 501 rows that have been returned by this query. Now, without going into too much detail, I've got a lot of other blog articles about how you can use DAX as a query language, but suffice to say that this query returns every single row in the customer table, basically every row that I want. And if you note here, just even without understanding a lot about DAX, you can see that there's a top end function returning a 501, and that's the number of rows that have been returned. Now, this is a technique that Power BI Desktop and indeed PowerBI.com use so that it doesn't have to go and fetch all the data, even if only a subset of the data is visible. So if you look at this visual here, as I scroll down the page, just look what happens here to this little icon here, the scroll bar icon. As I scroll down the page, as I'm getting closer to the first 501 rows that have been returned, notice that the scroll bar's coming all the way down the bottom. And in a moment, you'll notice another query was sent through to the database, and this extended. And so as I scroll down, watch, there'll be another query. Another query got generated. So this is a little efficiency technique that Power BI Desktop uses. It will only fetch 501 rows, which is basically 500 plus the total row if needed. And that's just an efficient way of sending the query and not putting too much load on the engine. So if you come back now to this query, this is the part of the query that just fetches 501 rows. But this part of the query fetches everything. And so I actually don't need any of this. I can just delete that. And I don't even need to define this as a variable. I can just go evaluate. I don't need the equal sign. And so basically, if I run this query, I'll just run this query now. You'll see that it returns the 18,484 rows. That's the number of rows in the database. Now, I just wanted to show you this in DAX Studio first. I'm going to go through this process again directly inside Excel. Okay, so I'm going to jump back here to Power BI Desktop. I'm going to clear this, I'll refresh the visual, and I'm going to copy my query. And now I'm going to use another third-party tool called Analyze in Excel. This is available from SQL BI. And click Analyze in Excel, and that's going to fire up a new instance of Excel that is connected to Power BI Desktop running on my computer. The next step is to build a pivot table. You only need a very simple pivot table. So all I'm going to do is bring total sales. Once you have this pivot table, double click on the cell. So double click here. That generates this table. And then what I'm going to do is right click the table, edit the query, and I'm going to replace this code, which happens to be MDX, and I'm going to paste the query that I copied from the performance tool. Now, it's actually a little bit hard to edit in here, so it might be useful just to do this inside Notepad. So I'll paste the query, and remember, all I need is this bit of code here. So I don't want all of this. I just need the summarize column, and I need to add evaluate. So I'm going to add evaluate, copy the code, control C, and then come back and just replace the code here. And when I do that, I get exactly what I need. And now I'm just going to format this. So let me get rid of these two blank rows. It's actually not possible to return exactly the column names that I want here. So I have to actually type over the top. This is a little bit of a manual process, but it's one off every time you refresh the query. So this will be the customer number. So now I've got that formatted nicely. And now that I've got this inside Excel, I can come up to page layout and I can use the standard formatting tools. So I can come up here and I can go print titles. I want my print, I want to repeat this row at the top. I can come under page. I want this to fit to one page and as many pages tall as required. If I want to, I can change it to landscape. It really depends. Let me just do a print preview on that. And you can see that this is exactly what I want. And once I've done that, I can actually go export to a PDF. And I'll just drop this on my desktop. I won't rename it. And that's going ahead and publishing the PDF for me. And now that I've opened that PDF, you can see that I've got a nice formatted paginated report with repeated headings at the top of each page. And this is a nice, quick and easy way to produce a paginated report. Very low code, a little bit of manipulation on the code generated by Power BI Desktop, but very easy to get up and running.